Alright guys, I got a little bit of explaining to do. So better fasten your seatbelts. You see, a few videos ago I picked up a new project truck. It was unplanned, so let's check it out real quick.
Also, I might add that it's taken me like 3 weeks to make this video because things keep getting interrupted. I've already made this intro before. What the? That was like perfect timing. Hey! Well, I was gonna make a video about my Toyota I just picked up, but that was not planned. That was funny. What's up?
What's happening?
Not much.
Trying to figure out how many miles it was, roughly.
That was good timing.
That was pretty good. I stopped to get gas too, and it took me an hour for the time I left to get here, so that's not bad at all.
It's about how long it takes me to get here in my Jeep.
Is it?
Yeah. No, I was just started making a video. I just pressed record, and then I heard you honking. I was like, what? That's awesome. So, let's try it again. So I picked up this 78 Hilux SR5 a few weeks ago from a family friend. It was unplanned. They came into my work and said, hey man, I have this truck on my property. If you come get it, it's yours. And so Zach and I loaded up the trailer and went and snagged her. She is a little bit dirty on the inside. I haven't even really touched it. But the best part about this truck is that it's an SR5. You know what that stands for? Super Rocket 5. A couple weeks ago, I was given some random keys for the truck, so we're gonna jump back to that real quick. All right, let's climb in this Mama Jamba. Whew, it's cold out here. Ooh, she's comfy. Okay, so the guy, what pocket? Did I lose him already? Oh shit, hold on. Okay, I'm back. So the guy gave me these keys, and he said, I'm pretty sure they're for the Toyota, but I'm not sure. But I'm pretty sure, but I'm not sure. So I'm not sure. So let's find out. Obviously, it's not gonna start because, you know, there's no battery in it. Well, actually, there is a battery in it, but it's probably dead. Let me get my hands to work. My hands are so cold right now. I can't hold on to these things. Okay, let's see here. They don't even fit in the ignition. Okay, these might not be it. I can't even hold on to them. Yeah, I'm pretty sure these aren't it. They don't even fit in the ignition. Which means they probably won't fit in the doors either. Oh. Yeah, no. I'm gonna have to source an ignition and some door locks because those don't work. As you can see, they weren't the right keys. So I ended up just pulling the ignition out, the ignition switch, and trying to start it with the screwdriver. I popped a battery in it and put some juice to it, just clicked. And so last weekend that I was here, I pulled the starter out of it and I tested it. It failed. So I have a new starter that I want to throw in it. But before I do that, I'm gonna take the battery out of here. I'm gonna pop it back on the charger because it's been sitting for a while, get some extra juice in it, and see what happens. She's a little low on juice. Let her charge up. Let's kick it up a notch. Also, We got a tire machine now.
And also,
I went and bought a blast cabinet.
We'll eventually put that together. While that battery's charging, I'm going to try to see if I can get that starter in the truck.
I have to see if I can find my smaller tripod. I think it's in here.
There she is.
This truck has way bigger plans.
The reason why I'm working on the mini truck first is because the 4x is going to be like a complete frame off teardown. Oh! My head fell off. So I'm going to mess with the mini truck first, see if I can kind of get it running so there's not a whole bunch of dead vehicles around here. And then, excuse me, and then we'll get back to the 4x because that's going to be so much going on with that thing.
I also need to get a jack underneath it. And so I'm just going to throw it in the bed of the truck and drive it over there.
Because I'm not carrying that jack all the way over there, dude.
Oh, God. So the old starter has an R terminal, which is strictly used just for startup. It bypasses the system and it gives the starter full 12 volts just in startup. But on the truck itself, I can't see any wiring for it, and I know that it goes to the positive side of the coil. So I might have to dig around to see if I want to throw in the R terminal. You don't have to, it's just for startup, it's just to give it some extra juice. But it might be smart if it's having trouble starting.
But I might dig around, see if I can figure out if there's a harness in there, if I just need to run and a jumper wire to the positive side. And that's usually used on vehicles with points to give it extra juice.
Also, I might have just thrown a wrench in this whole thing. I just realized on this starter that I got, this power wire is fucked up already.
I don't know if I want to try to silicone it or fix it or... Son of a bitch, man. It's gonna take me a month to make this video, I swear to God. Well, I'm not gonna throw that starter in there because I don't want it to have issues with the wire already being broke off on the end. So, kind of sucks because I work 6 days a week, I only get one day off. So that's why these videos take so damn long to make. So, I don't know, we'll see what happens.
Gotta love reman parts, right? Also, those frogs are loud.
Speaking of frogs, I just found one in the shop. Hey, buddy. Are you hurt? Why are you doing that? Probably don't want to be in here. You'll get stuck in here. Oh, I need something to put him in. Okay. You're just gonna have to trust me. Please don't. Here, go. There you go. Okay. Let's take you outside. Just don't want you to get trapped in here. There you go, buddy. Back outside. I'll just let you do your thing. Here. Going out. There you go. Be free, little buddy.
So once again, I got nothing done, like always in all of my YouTube videos. Dude, making YouTube videos kills me. I can never seem to get anything done in them. I am so sorry. I am trying so hard to get content and get stuff done, but I just suck at it. But I do appreciate some of the people that understand and that follow along. I think I might just post this video anyway, because if I add on to this video, it's just gonna be way too long. And so hopefully the next video is going to be getting a starter that's not messed up straight from the box and go on from there. I'm really hoping I can get some progress done on this truck, because I would like to be able to move it under its own power. I know it's gonna need a slave cylinder as well and probably some fuel issues, but we'll get there when that time comes, because the time hasn't come yet. And so I really appreciate the two people that watch this dumb shit. I promise you guys, I'm trying so much harder to make better videos, but it's For me, it's not easy. It's not easy for me to make a good video. I just struggle, but I'm trying. So, I appreciate the 2, 3, 4, 5 of you. And I'm almost at 500 subs, guys. I'm at like 5 people away. So, hang in there, people. Please, hang in there. I'm trying to make better stuff. So, anyway, adios.
This one, right?
Yep.
Oh. It's really easy.
No fucking way.
It runs really good for 93 years old. When I was the only driver.
Oh, that's reverse again.
I know, my bet was that way, and I was reverse thinking I was in first.
I guess that's why my bet was.
There you go.
Hey,
there you go. Perfect.
You're doing all right.
There you go. Good job.
Got it.
Good old girl.
So, what do you think?
Every time
I have an anxiety,
every time you drive it, it gets easier and easier.
Yeah, I can imagine. I mean, it's like driving stick for your first time.
Dude, I was terrified to drive this thing the first time I drove it.
I was scared to drive this thing when I first got it. Just, you know.
This thing does not fucking... I don't understand this thing.
Oh my god, I'm too old to do this.